politicians are hypocrites. They don't wanna listen. If I'm insane, the fame made a proper change. It wasn't nothing like the game. It's just me against the world.
Me against the world.
Nothing to lose. It's just me against the world, baby.
Me against the world.
Got me stuck in the game. It's just me against the world.
Oh,
I got nothing to lose. It's just me against the world, baby.
I was reading today a copy of the New York Times. And I was really interested to read in there about Barack Obama's friends from Chicago. Turns out, one of his earliest supporters is a man who, according to the New York Times, was a domestic terrorist and part of a group that, quote, launched a campaign of bombings that would target the Pentagon and the U.S. Capitol. Man.
On this issue, general theme of patriotism in your relationships, a gentleman named William Ayers. He was part of the Weather Underground in the 1970s. They bombed the Pentagon, the Capitol, and other buildings. He's never apologized for that. And in fact, on 9/11, he was quoted in the New York Times saying, "I don't regret setting bombs. I feel we didn't do enough." An early organizing meeting for your state Senate campaign was held at his house, and your campaign has said you're friendly. Can you explain that relationship for the voters and explain to Democrats why it won't be a problem?
Georgia, but this is an example of what I'm talking about. This is a guy who lives in my neighborhood, who's a professor of English in Chicago, who I know and who I have not received some official endorsement from. He's not somebody who I exchange ideas from on a regular basis. The notion that somehow as a consequence of me knowing somebody who engaged in detestable acts 40 years ago when I was 8 years old, somehow reflects on me and my values, doesn't make much sense, George. The fact is that I'm also friendly with Tom Coburn, one of the most conservative Republicans in the United States Senate, who during his campaign once said that it might be appropriate to apply the death penalty to those who carried out abortions. Do I need to apologize for Mr. Coburn's statements? Because I certainly don't agree with those either. So this kind of game in which anybody who I know, regardless of how flimsy the relationship is somehow their ideas could be attributed to me, I think the American people are smarter than that. They're not going to suggest somehow that that is reflective of my views, because it obviously isn't.
Well, I think that is a fair general statement, but I also believe that Senator Obama served on a board with Mr. Ayers for a period of time, the Woods Foundation, which was a paid directorship position, and if I'm not mistaken, that relationship with Mr. Ayers on this board continued after 9/11 and after his reported comments, which were deeply hurtful to people in New York. And I would hope to every American, because they were published on 9/11, and he said that he was just sorry they hadn't done more. And what they did was set bombs. And in some instances, people died. So it is, you know, I think it is, again, an issue that people will be asking about.
I know it seems hard sometimes, but remember one thing. Through every dark night, there's a bright day after that. So no matter how hard it gets, stick your chest out.